and Camelot!
Sir Bevedere, how goes the quest? What? Well then, Sir Lancelot. Ah, this is a disaster. Can't anyone help?
Yo, what's up, King Arthur?
Sir Mix-a-Lot.
This table's wrong, but it should be round. King Arthur can't hear a sound. When a knight tries to talk, that brother's gotta walk about half a freaking block to be heard. Can't hear a word, cause this table is so absurd. Us knights got much to discuss, cause this table's ridiculous.
Don't be ridiculous.
Bevedere came here.
Yo, can you pass me some beer?
Say what? It's 20 feet by 80. Can't even flirt with ladies. Better have long arms when you're having a meal if you trying to cop a feel.
Ah, dudes, it's your boy Asian Psycho, aka Toy Sniper 98. I've got a week break before the next event shows up, so let's get these videos out of the way, shall we? Finally, we get around to making a video on Type Moon's poster girl, Artoria Pendragon, the OG gender swap character, or one of them, I suppose. And for God's sake, fucking perverted eggplant, her name isn't Altria! At level 90, Ahoga Girl has 15,150 HP and 11,221 attack, and with Full Grail she has 16,597 HP and 12,283 attack. She has standard star absorption and star gen for a saber, 0.86% MP charge attack, 3% MP charge defense, a 21% death rate, and she is lawful good. She has a 2B2A deck with a Buster NP. Her quick card hits twice, her arts cards hit twice, her Buster cards hit once, and her extra attack hits three times. Saber's stats are well-rounded, as much as this term can be applied to a game like this. She has a good chunk of HP, so she can tank pretty well, and while her attack is on the lower end of things, it's not exactly bad, especially when you give her attack foes and then give her an offensive craft essence to work with on top of that. However, not much else is too noteworthy about her stats or deck. She has low hit counts across the board for her command cards, so she doesn't have good star gen overall, although her overall MP gain is rather decent just because of her raw MP gen rate at 0.86%. She also has one of the lower death rates in the game, so in case you're going against servants who can insta-kill, Artoria might not be a bad choice if insta-kill is a threat and she's not being counterclassed, if you really want to worry about that. Mini Lion King's first skill is Charisma B, which increases party attack from 9 to 18% on a 7 to 5 turn cooldown. Cool. Her second skill is Mana Burst A, which increases her Buster card performance from 30 to 50% for one turn on a 7 to 5 turn cooldown. Again. Sweet. And her third skill is Instinct A, which allows her to generate between 5 to 15 crit stars instantly, also on a 7 to 5 turn cooldown.
What the fuck?
Her two passive skills are Magic Resistance A, which increases her own debuff resistance by 20%, and Riding B, which increases her own quick card performance by 8%, which is borderline useless on someone with a 2B2A deck. Saber's NP is Excalibur, the single most called attack in all of anime history, or something like that. It's a Buster AoE NP that deals 300 to 500% damage and refunds Saber's NP gauge from 20 to 50% depending on overcharge level. Post interlude, it goes up to 400 to 600% damage scaling instead. You may have noticed by the tone of the video thus far, or maybe you could kind of tell from Saber's stats, deck, and skills, or maybe you already know where I'm about to go with this, but Futanari King is really straightforward. So straightforward, in fact, in everything that she does that this video would probably be as half as short as every other meme video that I've made so far. So for me to channel my inner not a whale and deliberately extend this video past 10 minutes so that I can get that little bit of extra ad revenue that'll so totally get me that thick and juicy YouTube money at the end of the month, this is the part of the video where I explain to you why you may have heard from people that Artoria isn't so great in this game.
Alex 19 isn't so great.
Okay, so let's start from the beginning. Saber was one of the OG servants to be made for this game, obviously, and as in we're talking 2015 JPFGO when you didn't even have good Chaldea Gate dailies, and gacha summons were fucking 4 Saint Quartz per fucking roll. You notice how some servants in this game only have 2 skills, and that NA has gotten 2 sets of these strengthening quests, quote-unquote, that sometimes add 3rd skills to some of those servants? Because back then, the devs initially designed servants to really only have 2 skills. So by giving Saber 3 skills, this was meant to differentiate her from the others. Because, oh, she's got 3 skills! Oh my god, that makes her so good, right? Woohoo! Instinct has a 3rd skill, that's so fucking amazing! Not! The problem was that the devs soon realized that the players wouldn't really like it as much if most of the servants only had 2 skills. So they started giving everyone 3 skills. But they didn't do anything with Saber's skill set to make her better, because evidently this isn't Saber's game, and that she's already had enough spotlight and other materials in the franchise or some fucking bullshit like that. Oh, and just as a disclaimer, I don't claim to know JPFGO history. This is just what I've heard and read a long time ago back in the day when I was first trying to get into the game, so please don't roast me, K, thanks, bye. What I do know, however, is that Saber's never been buffed ever since the beginning of the goddamn game, outside of that one interlude that buffs her MP damage scaling, but who the fuck cares? And no matter which tier list you look at, you're sure to see her down at the bottom somewhere. So now that we know the backstory of Saber getting shit on in this game, let's try to figure out how hard she gets shit on. For a servant to be quote-unquote good, especially nowadays, they need to have either skills that are unique and good, not just unique, or just plain good, or gimmicks that make them useful in the context of the game. Waver, in my opinion, is an example of the former, because all of his skills are stupid fucking good in the sense that you can use them whenever and with whomever, generally speaking. And Gilgamesh is an example of the latter, especially after his MP upgrade that we got recently just before XL0, because not only does he get a 30% boost to his MP damage just because he's motherfucking Gilgamesh, but his MP also has a gimmick that lets it deal even more damage against the vast majority of the servants in this game, again, just because he's motherfucking Gilgamesh. While on the other hand, I can ride anything girl has neither. She's an honest servant in a game where honest servants were good for maybe like the first year of the game. And then DW said,
"Fuck this shit, I'm out."
All of Saber's skills have exactly one effect. Charisma only boosts party attack, Mana Burst only boosts her buster cards, and for one turn at that, and Instinct only generates crit stars, and not even that many to begin with. It's nice that they all have relatively shorter cooldowns at max rank, but given their effects, and unless you're a god-tier farming whale, are her skills really worth all those Saber cookies, dragon fangs, talons, and scales? And to make things worse, most of her skill set is nowadays vastly outclassed by the shenanigans that servants who've been released closer to the present now have as skills. Why bother with charisma when you've got this fucking nerd who's got a skill that's more than doubly as effective and gives everyone 10% free MP charge, because why the fuck not? Why bother with instinct when you can just take star gen servants like Jackie Chan or CEs like 2030 to auto-generate those stars for you? And to drive the final nail in her coffin that's 6 feet beneath the top of the tier list, Saber's MP is AoE, and all its overcharge effect really does is refund her some of her MP gauge back. It helps make her NP slightly more spammable despite being a buster, but it's AoE, meaning that she isn't as good against boss servants, and as you've probably already noticed in this game by now, boss fights are kinda important. This means that Arc doesn't have the 2 things that makes a servant good in this game, good skills or the ability to fight bosses well, because while she has a skill that tremendously increases her damage output and mana burst, she doesn't have a survival skill like evade or guts, and relies on you or her teammates to keep her alive. So by this point you probably get the idea. Saber unfortunately just doesn't have a lot of things going for her, and that's more or less why people tell you that best Fate Stay Night girl isn't what you want in this game. But that's not what this video is about, is it? Ever wonder why I don't call these meme vids reviews? Because this video isn't to review a servant. This video is about how to use Dick Girl if you had to use her because you don't have a choice and she's the only 5-star servant that you have. So let's do just that. NTR King is a prime general battle candidate, just like Altera. In other words, she's perfect for battles that don't matter, i.e. random story battles and singularities, and for farming. Her command deck allows her to get her MP consistently and reliably with two arts cards, and dish out strong and consistent damage with her two buster cards. She's got charisma to buff everyone's damage, and instinct for a small bit of Star Gen support to help them kill shit a bit faster, and mana burst so that Excalibur can clear shit considerably faster. She's also fantastic for farming as well, as we've just mentioned, and perhaps more so than some of the other AoE sabers because mana burst just adds so much extra damage to her MP. Her charisma can also make MPs of her teammates all that much stronger, too. And that's really about it, though. But hey, you'll be doing a lot of farming, so she's not completely fucking useless, right? I mean, come on, I mean, at least her name isn't Gills or Giles or whatever. As my good friend Soberoni says,
she can fit on virtually any team.
No, seriously, as is like the waiver of sabers. You can put her literally into any team composition, you'll probably be fine. Again, if it's not a boss fight. Now that Jalter's in the game, though, do keep in mind that Saber does have the dragon trait, so Jalter's charisma can double buff Saber and help her hit a bit harder than you might expect. So, memes aside, Jalter and Saber can actually be a pretty potent combo. But do you really want to NTR Salter for Saber? It's simple. Just run Saber, Salter, and Jalter. Why bother with the NTR when you can just have a foursome with all of them? Just don't let Emiya find out about it. Thanks to Saber's general utility role, she's got a good range of CEs that she can use to good effect. For starters, Elzio and his lower rarity counterparts are good, obviously, because she's got a Buster-centric deck. And while the CE isn't released yet, but will be soon, in about a month or so, maybe, Golden Sumo is great on servants like Saber due to their general purpose role, but again, Golden Sumo is great on anyone anyway. MP spam CEs are good too, since Artoria does have some capacity of spamming her MP with the overcharge refund mechanic, two arts cards, and a pretty good MP generate, so things like Lewd Ilya, Divine Banquet, and Prisma Cosmos are in fact viable. Be careful with the damage CEs though, the MP damage ones anyway, because her MP is AoE, so they won't be ideal on her unless you're trying to like one-shot the third wave of Southwark or something. Support CEs or miscellaneous CEs like 2030, Bondcraftens like the Heroic Portraits or whatever they're called, or the Shop CEs that you can buy out for 5,000 mana prisms are also good on her, since she doesn't really need craft essences to do what she does best. And since she's got great HP, tank CEs and HP regen CEs help her stay alive even longer and makes it so that you don't really ever have to worry about babysitting her outside of dire situations. Conversely though, her big health pool, and I'm not talking about her chest by the way because we all know that's not big, makes her a good choice to hold taunt CEs so that she can buy the team some time for them to get their MPs charged or something without having to worry about getting hit. Her Bondcraft Essence Crown of the Stars increases party attack permanently by 15% when she's got it equipped and is on the field. This is a great Bond CE to use since it fits really well with her role as a general utility slash light offensive support servant. Sader is the epitome of mediocrity at Fate Grand Order. While I wish it weren't this way, because I really like her myself, since she's my very first 5-star servant back when I first made my account, and will forever be the only 5-star servant in my account whom I've gotten for completely fucking free, in a game where you have fucking Dio spamming laser beams out of fucking Sphinx heads, a dual-wielding swordswoman punching you in the face with some spirit demon or some shit, and her own personal advisor running around giving buster people bigger dicks, or in some cases new ones, Artoria just doesn't have a lot going for her. But what little she does have going for her, she does pretty damn well. Perhaps the tier list and all those things might tell you that on paper, Penguin King might as well be another USO, but if you do have her, try her out, and see if you can't figure out a way to put her to use that doesn't involve feeding her to another servant just because you're pissed off that she spooked you on Jalter's gotcha. So yeah, don't count her out just yet. Also, DW, Avalon Wen. And that's all you need to know about Takauchi's waifu. Next video is going to be on Drunk Stripperoni. I'll be doing a somewhat drunk stream when her event comes out, so be on the lookout for that. I may or may not have a webcam installed for that stream, but don't be disappointed if I don't because I'm just an average motherfucker. Thanks for watching, don't pull off Saber's Ahoge, and until next time, deuces.